Storms hitting the metro later tonight.
Yeah, John is keeping his eye on how much more rain we could be in for, John. And John, that's the last thing we need right now. More
rain. Last thing we need. Yes, we got a chance tonight. Once we can get through tonight's chance, it is going to be much lower and drier for the rest of the week. Hey, gorgeous shot here this morning. 65, sun is already up. The dew point is 61. So it's hot and humid already, especially in the southwest pocket. We're in the upper 60s, and that's where I think it could really get cooking today. There's a heat advisory, 1 p.m. to 8 p.m. We could see the heat index at 110. Now, not 110 here in the cities, but a warm one. Temperatures making it into the 80s, partly cloudy skies, and we're going to see thunderstorm chances not until 7 p.m. or later. We'll time it all out for you in your forecast. Coming up, CC.
Hey, good morning. Live look here in the Invergrove Heights area. Good morning if you're waking up there. Could see some slowdowns here if you're headed out the door within the next 30 minutes or so. Highway 55 in both directions going down to one lane here between Argenta Trail and Highway 52. The project was supposed to start at 7 o'clock this morning, but as you see here, the barrels are out. It looks like things started a little early. So just be aware of that. Some slowdowns could be in your morning commute. Wrapping up this weekend, this project, so just a heads up there. Right now, not really seeing any disturbances across the metro or any slowdowns. Really, I have a stalled vehicle in the Minneapolis area, 35W, but no crashes this Monday morning, which is great. So you should have a smooth commute to work, especially if you're leaving within the next hour. Of course, flooding is a big concern this morning. I focused on Henderson flooding just south of Shakopee when I saw you last half hour. Next, I'll be talking about some flooding in Le Sueur, making graphics to show you that right now. Alicia.
All right, CC, we will check back soon. Thank you. To our top story here at 6. Right now, as we've been saying all morning long, cities across the state are dealing with major flooding.
The rising water is causing road closures and evacuations in some places. We have team coverage this morning. So Audrey is live in St. Paul, where a busy road near downtown is shut down. But first, let's check in with Michelle in Waterville right now, where the National Guard is mobilizing today. Michelle.
Yeah, Jason, Alicia, what's behind me looks like a river, but of course we know it is in fact Main Street, though there's water as far as our eyes can see. At the request of the sheriff here, the Minnesota National Guard will be helping out with whatever they can to protect against flooding. No signs yet of where exactly they are right now, but as one resident told me, the Guard's presence is a glimmer of hope for this community. Now, there is just too much water here, yet the water is still rising. We heard county leaders say that in the last 24 hours, and that's also the reason they say what you're seeing now is the largest flooding Waterville has ever experienced. All weekend long, it's been all hands on deck. City leaders saying 60,000 sandbags have gone out to the people in need. 1,000 volunteers helping to pack those sandbags to guard against the areas still under threat.
I live in town here, and I'm lucky enough that the water hasn't affected my house, but I'm sure others would do the same living in town. Come and help someone who needs it.
And at this time, we know the city has enforced evacuations just yet, that being the latest word. But of course, we do know there are families out there who did decide to make that choice themselves to go out and leave this area. Coming up in 30 minutes, we'll hear from some of those families whose lives have been dramatically changed by all this flooding. Guys, back to you.
Just awful. All right, Michelle Beck reporting live for us. Thank you. An hour west of Waterville in Medelia, police are calling the flooding there an emergency situation. They're telling people to have an evacuation plan in place as the water rises. In the last 12 hours, police posted on Facebook, in order to prevent sewage backups, they're emergency pumping sewage down the streets to the river. So the standing water is probably not just water. Water is also rising on the Mississippi River and is expected to crest in St. Paul in the coming days.
Yeah, Audrey is near downtown right now where a busy road is shut down. Audrey, what are you seeing?
Yeah, so Jason and Alicia, you can see where I'm standing right here on 2nd Street at the entrance to Warner and Shepherd, where you can see road closures are in effect. You can see the signs, the sandbags, the banners, everything out here warning drivers, pedestrians, bikers to stay away from this part of the road and stay away from this part of the city. It's about a 3-mile stretch of road that they are concerned could flood due due to rising waters in the Mississippi River. Now, take a look at this map. It was provided to us by city officials. It's the area on the north side of the river between Eagle Parkway and Highway 61. You'll also run into closures on Water Street between the Yacht Club and the Marina. If you're in Lower Town, Jackson and Sibley Streets off of 2nd are now two ways to help local traffic get into some of these buildings on the corners. Now, the Mississippi is set to enter the moderate flood stage of 15 feet by around this afternoon. It's hovering this morning at just under 15 feet. They predict it'll reach the major flood stage of 17 feet by tomorrow and crest at 20 feet by Friday. Now, the record is 26 feet. That was set back in the 60s, so obviously we're still far from that, but 20 feet certainly is still concerning. Now, we're told that Governor Walz is actually going to be out here surveying the flooding, surveying the damage, talking just a little bit about what all of this flooding has done to the entire state. And these road closures out here will be in effect until any and all flood waters recede. And Jason, I know St. Paul is not the only, that's not the only area that is really struggling with these rising waters, this excessive rain. Tell us a little bit more about what you're seeing.
Yeah, we want to give you an update here on the Crow River in Delano. Now, that's expected to actually crest here in a couple of hours. It's going to crest today. So the latest is 19.43 feet. The crest is expected at 19.5. Now, on Friday, when I did this exact same update, the forecast was for this to hit 21 feet. We came in lower than the forecast because rain totals over the weekend was actually lower. It's hard to believe that. Now, you can see the record at 23.3 feet, so we're going to stay under the record. Now, when will we get out of the major flood stage? You really have to get until about Thursday. Thursday will dip back down into moderate. And if all things stay the same in the forecast and we see lower rain totals this week, then we can get out of the flood stage by this upcoming weekend.
Fingers crossed on that, John. Thank you. And you're going to want to stay on top of this rising water. So grab your phone right now and scan the QR code on your screen to download the KARE 11 weather app. It has live updates, radar, and custom forecasts whenever you want. You can find it for free in any app store.
Another news headlines this morning. Right now, a man is fighting for his life after being shot by Brooklyn Park police just over 24 hours ago. The BCA is now investigating, but here's what we know. As of this morning, police were called to the home for a 7-month-old not breathing. The baby later died at the hospital. Family members say the dad threatened to harm himself and locked himself in a room upstairs. When police arrived, they say they encountered a man with a gun and one officer shot him. The Hennepin County Sheriff's Office is looking into the death of the baby.
Well, tomorrow at the state capitol, groups from the University of Minnesota will testify about an alleged pattern of anti-Israel and anti-Jewish incidents on campus. The Jewish Community Relations Council, Hillel, and university reps will be speaking on the campus climate following a days-long encampment that ended early last month. Protesters calling on the university to divest from companies they say are complicit in war crimes. They will discuss the school's handling of the incidents and outline a plan to move forward.
All right, it's finally time. Some of the best gymnasts in the world are descending on the Twin Cities this week for the U.S. Olympic team trials. The trials officially kick off at Target Center, but to kick things off, Governor Walz and other state leaders will be at Target Plaza today to declare this Gymnastic City USA Week in Minnesota. The U.S. Gymnastics Olympic trials run from the 27th through the 30th at Target Center. And starting today, we will have live coverage throughout our show, so be sure to stick with us on KARE 11 on air and online for all things Team USA Gymnastics.
The kickoff.